Then the 12 called the multitude of the disciples unto them and said,
We will give ourselves continually to prayer and to the ministry of the word.
And the saying pleased the whole multitude, and they chose Stephen. And the word of God increased, and the number of disciples multiplied in Jerusalem greatly, and a great company of the priests were obedient to the faith.
And Stephen, full of faith and power, did great wonders and miracles among the people.
Then there arose certain of the synagogue, disputing with Stephen, and they were not able to resist the wisdom and the spirit by which he spake. Then they suborned men, which said, We have heard him speak blasphemous words against Moses and against God. And they stirred up the people and the elders and the scribes, and came upon him and brought him to the council. Then said the high priest, Are these things so? And Stephen said,
Ye do always resist, always resist. The Holy Ghost, as your fathers did, as your fathers did, so do ye. Which of the prophets have not all fathers persecuted? Have not your fathers persecuted? And thee have slain them which should be for of the coming of the just one.
When they heard cut to the heart, and they gnashed on him with their teeth. But he, full of the Holy Ghost, said,
Behold, I see the heavens opened, and Son of Man standing on the right hand of God. Then
they cried out with a loud voice,
ran
upon him
with one
accord,
and cast him out
of the city.
and the witnesses laid down their clothes at a young man's feet.
Whose name was Saul.
And they stoned Stephen,
calling upon God and saying,
Lord Jesus, receive my spirit.
And he kneeled down
and cried with a loud voice,
Lord, lay not this sin to their charge.
And when he had said this,